This is the Rasberry Pi. No, not the kind that's edible. This particular Pi is a miniature marvel of computing. What makes it so special? Well, for starters, it's a fully functional computer with HD video playback for under 30 quid. For another, this comes in a package roughly the size of a business or credit card. And for a third, it was created by a charity called the Rasberry Pi Foundation to bring greater computer literacy and better programming skills to children everywhere. Mind you, it's no Luca. To squeeze the Pi into its attractive price bracket, all non-essentials are left out. What you get is a bare board with all its bits out in plain view. However, because the Pi doesn't put out too much heat or require active cooling, you can build a case out of almost anything from Lego to cardboard, and there's a range of pre-made cases available from various third parties. Connectivity is truly superb for such a tiny device, especially on the B version of the Rasberry Pi. Next to the Ethernet jack, there are two USB 2 ports that can be used to hook up peripherals or adapters, and this can be further expanded with a powered hub. For video, there's a full-size HDMI port, making the Rasberry Pi compatible with practically every TV and monitor out there. For older displays that don't support digital, the Rasberry Pi even has an analog composite RCA video output, which can be used with SCART via an adapter. Stereo audio can be output over a 3.5mm jack, or you can get the full 5.1 surround sound through the aforementioned HDMI. At the Rasberry Pi's base, there's a full-size SD card slot that caters for the system's only permanent storage. The rear also sports a micro USB port, but that's just for power rather than data. The Rasberry Pi Foundation doesn't bundle an adapter, but most of the ones used for tablets or smartphones will work. So what are the specs like? You get a very slow 700 MHz ARM 11 CPU and far more capable Video Core 4 GPU, backed by 256 MB of RAM. For permanent storage, a 4GB SD card is the recommended minimum. To boot the Rasberry Pi, you'll need to install one of the available open source operating systems. Currently, Debian-based Wheezy is the OS of choice, unless you want to use the Pi as a media center, in which case a Raspberry-enhanced version of XBMC is probably the way to go. As Wheezy doesn't use graphics acceleration yet, even basic navigation in its graphical interface is a bit slow. Simple tasks like browsing the web are certainly manageable, but you need a little bit of patience. On the other hand, thanks to its powerful graphics core, the Pi has little trouble playing back HD video in XBMC, OpenELEC, or using one of the media players available for Wheezy. NeedOS is particularly straightforward to install and you'll need a computer to set them up, or you can buy a preloaded SD card. Read our full review to get more details on this delicious tiny slice of computing.